So I was really pleasantly surprised to see that we had some really interesting news in regards to this week's issue of Shonen Jump magazine, because it is surrounding, of course, the Bleach exposition. However, there does seem to be some tidbits of which I'm very interested to speak about, because it seems that when I posted this, kind of got people's head scratching a little bit, to which I didn't really think of at first. But anyway, I do want to show this, of course. This is the scan that I got this morning. You see at the very top, of course, just a little preview of what the exhibit's going to be looking like, showing a little picture of Orihime and the Everything But The Rain timeline. I can't wait to see what inside's going to look like and how they're going to lay it out. Very jealous. Can't be there, you know, pandemic and whatnot, but you know, we have to just take it as it is. Of course, if you're a Bleach Brave Souls user as well, there is some good news for you guys, kind of, maybe not kind of. There seems to be the 60th million download celebration in regards to them giving you essentially a 5-star ticket. Now, I don't understand how this is going to correlate worldwide. Now, of course, as far as I'm aware, it says here, as I have the translation, again, it's a rough translation, so take it as you will. Special wallpaper of a limited Bleach Brave Souls collaboration from December 18th. If you log into the campaign during the campaign period, you will get a 5-star gacha ticket. If you read the 2D code of the leaflet distributed at the venue, you can get in a Bleach Brave Soul original. Now, of course, this can mean two things. Obviously, one, there's going to be a QR code at the venue on the leaflet. So if you take your phone and scan that code, chances are you can get some rewards, or maybe it's even regarding the 5-star ticket. We're quite unsure at the moment, and we'll have to see how it goes, especially with overseas people as well. So hopefully someone can leak that online so all of us can kind of get involved and get that, especially if it's an exclusive unit too. I'm pretty sure people are really gonna be bummed out if they can't get that as well. Chances are though, you're probably gonna scan it and it's probably not gonna be available in your region. Yeah, different servers and whatnot, so that might cook you as well. Other than that, still a little cool thing for K-Lab to get involved in, as we know they are part of the sponsors for the exposition. So that's a very interesting thing as well, and you can take that as you will. Obviously, we have some merchandise that's going to be releasing slowly over the week, so more stuff is going to get announced. Of course, this tells me that there's going to be a shop at the event, or there's going to be an online store. Again, make that money. They've already got the money from the sponsors paying for the exhibit, but of course, they're making in loads of money on Club Kubo anyway, and they're going to make loads of money on the exhibit, as well as the administration tickets as well. So again, I just see nothing but positive things for this exhibit, and I feel like it's going to be really successful. But I guess the interesting thing that everybody wants to talk about is that little picture at the very bottom of Ichigo, looking quite like a villain, as one would say. Or as I would personally say, the face that Ichigo makes when Orihime says, let's go for round two. She's gonna regret that ability to reverse time in the sheets, I'm telling you boys, because my man is a menace. And that's how Kazui was made, and that's why he's so powerful. Anyway, yeah, so this is a very interesting scan to say the least. Now, this translation doesn't really say much. It's basically just saying in Weekly Shonen Jump 36 to 37, of which the chapter of the Hell chapter that was in Weekly Shonen Jump magazine is basically going to be having a one-shot release for electronic media, which means it's going to be released as a digital one-shot and released for people to buy it. There has been some speculation online, and that speculation online is the fact that it's having a digital release and it's going to be out there means that they're nipping it in the bud and that there's not going to be any more content in regards to Hell arc, and that is complete and utter bollocks. And I'll tell you why, because Burn the Witch back in 2018 had a one shot. It was 60 plus pages long. It had a physical release in regards with Bleach Jet art book, as well as a digital release, and guess what happened to that? That still became a series. So I don't think people get in the grasp that just because it's getting released as a one-shot for 70 plus pages, that this is the end or be all for the continuation for the Bleach manga. And this makes a lot of sense because, again, in Shueisha's mind, at the end of the day, they don't know when they can release a volume with the one shot involved in. I mean, obviously we had Burn the Witch, and in that volume we had the one shot and the chapters 1 to 4. So that was really cool, and it was a very, I think it was like a 260, 220 page manga. So, you know, they definitely got their money's worth, as well as their money's worth with the Bleach Jet art book. But also at the same time, they don't know when Kubo wants to pick up that pen and do manga for the new arc, because he's busy with Burn the Witch, he's busy with the exposition, and he's busy with the anime. Spider-Man is really busy with stuff at the moment, so he's taking his time, especially when it comes to Burn the Witch, especially because we know that's been confirmed for a season 2. He's definitely going to take his time with the new arc, and I don't think the new arc is even going to be relevant until perhaps towards the end of the anime, or until we get close to the end of the Blood War, and then we'll kind of see where Kubo goes from there. So for Shueisha, they would like to monetize on this chapter. I'm pretty sure they would also like to see people's kind of perspective on if they like it or not, and see what the sales figures say in regards to, sure, people might have receptive well to it in Shonen Jump magazine, but what are the sales saying? And if the sales for the one shot do extremely well, even if it's digital, then that's going to tell Shueisha, hey, people like this arc, people want more of this arc. And of course, that's why it was left on like an open-ended chapter. That's when they can go to Kubo, okay, people really want this, are you interested in doing it? And then give him that promotional value to come back to Jump to do that, maybe in between Burn the Witch. So what this tells me is that this is, without a shadow of doubt in my mind and with absolute confidence, that this is the correct procedure to go, especially if you want a continuation of the Hellverse chapters. So it's getting viewer retention, seeing where Bleach would place on that board of demand, and then acting accordingly to how they would market it and promote it in the future, and especially evolving around the anime too. So again, I wouldn't stress too much about if there's going to be a new season of Bleach. If anything, it's moving towards the right direction for a continuation. So again, think positive about this. I will say though, if I have any kind of influence with any of you guys at the moment, I will say, please, when this comes out on December, what was it? It will say on screen that I do recommend, even if you can't speak Japanese, that when this comes out, again, follow me on Twitter, subscribe to the channel, because I'll let you know when this comes out. Please just go buy it. Even if you can't understand it, just go show that love, show that support, get that really cool, you know, front cover of the chapter, if you want to call it that, the cover of the one shot, and just show some love and support. You know, I always criticize people on Twitter, you know, people who were fans of Samurai 8, people who were fans of all these series that got cancelled in Shonen Jump, for example, Boruto fans, Black Clover fans, people who show big hype on Twitter but don't actually back it up. I want you guys to back it up. When this one shot comes out, I want you guys to try your best to try and support this as much as you can. Go buy the digital version. I'll throw over the link on Twitter, I'll throw over the link on all the socials, I'll even make a YouTube post about it, but be subscribed, do follow, and keep up to date. Other than that, really cool piece of news we got this week. And yeah, tell me what you guys, of course, think in the comment section down below. Are you excited for the BBS thing? Are you excited to see more information on the expo? Are you excited to see where the Hellverse is going to go as we proceed forward? So with that being said, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers there. You guys, of course, have this fine day, been handsome as always, people. Peace out.